It's good to be back one last time. The theme for this year's CUNA is initiative. Now, I'm certain there is a very eloquently put dictionary definition that I could reference, but to me, initiative is taking that wild leap of faith, even when you don't think you'll make the jump. It is being that first person to say, I'm going to try. And for a lot of you here, that means getting behind a podium. Podiums and microphones are very useful tools. You can stand behind a podium and speak into a microphone, and a room of 1,400 students will stop and listen to you. But they don't listen to the podium or the microphone. They listen to the words passionately scribbled onto a piece of paper the night before. They listen to hours you spent researching an issue. They listen to your ideas on how to discern between what is good and what is necessary for world betterment. They listen to you. And the podium and the microphone are very powerful tools. But that's all they are. Tools. You are what makes them powerful. And sure, they can grab someone's attention, but your words and convictions are what will make people listen. You are what will make people care. And speaking about issues you're passionate about and doing it loudly and fearlessly, that is bravery. Raising your placard, that's initiative. Making the conscious decision to be recognized as someone who's willing to speak. Someone who's willing to try and be an influence to a group of people with their words. Someone who's willing to try. When you raise your hand to be called on, you are raising your hand for the millions of people that you represent. Having the audacity to throw your hand into the air as if to say, my people have a place in this discussion. That's initiative. And you are showing to the world that the country or nation that you wear on your name tag has a place in the international community. You validate the needs of millions of people. And that can be daunting. But every world-changing thing is. And that is what you signed up for when you walked into the Galt House. This is the role you took on when you decided to be a part of the Kentucky United Nations Assembly. You know, it's weird. I've heard a lot of you refer to these conferences as the why world. Many of you have claimed that this is your escape, per se. And I'm going to be honest, that worries me. Over the years, I've witnessed exemplary work from students in this program. I know that I will see that from you as well. The future of this program is bright, and by extension, so is the future of our world. But only when you transfer what happens here into your everyday life. The things you debate here and create are in the same realm as those created and debated in the world outside of, in the environment outside of this place. This is not your escape. This is you walking onto the battlefield, attacking issues head on. The rest of the world cannot afford for you to differentiate this conference from life outside of it because you are the people who are going to change it for them. You can't just decide to try and change the world once a year. It is a constant and a merciless journey, but it is the most important one you will ever make. So whether you are here or outside of these walls, there is still poverty. People still die each day. There are corrupt governments. People are beaten and bloodied. People are dying of hunger. Hungry for enough food to feed themselves and their families. Hungry for an education or equality or a chance. Just a chance at a higher quality of life. That doesn't change when you walk into these doors, and it won't change when you leave them unless you make it change. Your responsibility to those people as their ambassadors is unchanging within and outside of these walls. And as much as I wish there was, there is no why world to escape to. The environment you have entered here is the one that supports and uplifts each of your individual voices is the same world that will silence you when you leave this environment. You know, there are a lot of things about me that make it hard for my voice to carry much weight outside of this conference. Those things just don't exist here. Here, something I say or something you say matters. Then and there, it is worth listening to. Now, when you leave this place and you decide to stand for something you believe in, you will be silenced. When you show any signs of creativity or innovation, you will be told, good idea, hold on to that for the next 10 years. That part of your life, the one where you sit and wait, that's over. It ended the minute you walked in here. And I'm sorry if that seems like me springing this up on you unexpectedly, but you're ready for it. And I know that you're ready for it because you took the time to be here today. So embrace the power of your voice and believe in your capacity to make change. You don't have a podium? Build one. No microphone? Shout until your voice aches, until your words do break barriers and your passions do not leave a single soul untouched. You know, a lot of times people make the argument, I know what we do here is about real issues and they affect real people, but nothing we do here at CUNA actually changes anything. It's a valid argument. I mean, if I give a speech about universal education, that doesn't mean anyone is any closer to receiving it. But this is what I tell to the people who make that argument. It will. I mean, look around the room. Go ahead. Actually, look. I want you to remember the faces that you see, because the rest of the world is going to someday. You are future leaders and policymakers and artists and doctors and inspirers and world changers. And you're all sitting here together in one room as one collective body. You see, this place is where you learn the ropes. Here you are taught not only how to use a podium, but how to build one. You are taught how to make people listen. You are taught how to lead. Some of you here have leapt before. You'll stand back and take a running start and throw yourselves into the effort of making your voice heard. For others, it's not that simple, and that is completely okay. Some of you need to be pushed. Now, every speech you give, every friend you make is a call to action, a push. And sometimes, that's really all people need. Just to be inspired, to have someone push them into their running start. Now, I do not doubt your capacity to lead, or your capacity to lead others to do the same. And it is that same unflinching confidence in you that reminds me of one quote every time I look at you in the General Assembly. Never doubt that a small group of thoughtful, committed citizens can change the world. Indeed, that is all that ever has. Margaret Mead. Now, despite what we may look like gathered in this room, in the face of all the world's issues, we are a very, very small group. But we are a thoughtful group. And we are a committed group. And we will go on to change the world. So, CUNA 2016, I encourage you to raise your placards. Take your place behind the podium, speak. Don't worry if your legs shake and your hands tremble. It's normal, I promise. I encourage you to take advantage of everything this conference has to offer you and to do so to the fullest extent. I encourage you to be passionate and to be fearless. I encourage you to leap.